female versus male serial killers. From their twisted motives and sinister methods to their choice of victims, female serial killers often exhibit distinctly different behaviors than their infamous male counterparts. Now, a surprising new study could explain why. Today, Daily Mail TV is taking an in-depth look at just what exactly makes female serial killers tick.
A loving wife, a doting mother, a respected nurse, each one a convicted serial killer.
I think society is in disbelief that there would be female serial killers at all.
Forensic psychologist Dr. Judy Ho explained to Daily Mail TV how female serial killers have a disturbingly different MO when it comes to executing their deadly crimes.
In female serial killers, the motive is often financially based. It's about improving their lifestyle. Dana Sue Ray murdered 3 people for financial gain. She said that it was really to keep up with her excessive spending habits. You can compare that to Ted Bundy, who had murdered at least 30 women, and there's often rape and brutality involved. Common methods for males tend to be more direct, so guns are often used. There's a lot of blood. The crime scene can be a mess. Whereas female serial killers, a lot of the methods that they use are things like poison.
So what causes distinctly female predatory patterns? Dr. Ho points to a new study that may hold the key.
There is a new theory. In the ancestral environment, females wanted to gather resources so that they could better the lives of themselves and their children. Whereas males, they wanted to spread their seed more biologically. And you actually see some of this pattern in female serial killers versus males. Female serial killers tend to gather their victims in their home, in their workplace. Males tend to go far and wide. They leave their homes to go and stalk their prey.
In a chilling case in point, Angel of Death serial killer nurse Kristen Gilbert was convicted of murdering 4 hospital patients in her care, compared to Son of Sam serial killer David Berkowitz, who hunted his victims.
I think the theory is creating a buzz because it's potentially a tool in crime detection.
But according to Dr. Ho, there are exceptions to the theory.
I'm on my way to the chamber, nothing stopping it.
Eileen Warnos was a big exception. She was a prostitute, and she claimed that she killed 7 people in the span of a year at point-blank range with a gun because they were aggressing upon her and that it was really just for revenge. It's so against what we think of any female killers. She was using such a lethal means, and these men were strangers. So again, that idea of her gathering the people that she already knows, people she already has relationships with, didn't really apply to her.
As we see in the terrifying case of Carla Homolka, not all female serial killers act alone. Sometimes they team up with a romantic partner.
So one of these serial killing couples, Carla Homolka and Paul Bernardo, they started killing because Carla wasn't a virgin. And Paul convinced her that the solution to the problem was to try to find other minors who were virgins, and then he could have his way with them. And in fact, the first victim, sadly, was Carla's own 15-year-old sister. And after this, she found at least 2 other minors that Paul brutalized, and then they both were involved in the killing. They went just as far as to kind of combine these typical female and male serial killer ideas.
Finally, Dr. Ho shared what she believes is the biggest misconception when it comes to female serial killers.
Oftentimes people think that female killers, if they were to do such a thing, it might have been an accident. It was in the heat of the moment. They didn't mean to actually kill this person. It's totally untrue. I think with the right kind of premeditated motive, they are capable, and they have justified it to themselves of why it's okay to do this.
And thanks to Dr. Judy Ho for sharing her insight on this chilling topic.